I met Ashley at a restaurant that we work at. She's adorable and very loving. It's been about, what, 6 months?
Yeah.
We've been dating.
Cocktails!
Right. My favorite.
I was like hanging out with some of my friends and they were just asking me about him. And you know, obviously things are really good.
He's really, really great, guys. He's so cute.
And he's so hot.
One of my friends suggested something that she had tried.
Last week, I got this toy for us to play with.
It's this little device that you put into your underwear.
Oh my gosh, really?
Yes. And it has this button, and you push the button and it acts like a vibrator. And I like already have it planted in my underwear, so I'm like ready to go. And kind of just handed him a remote and was like, here you go.
What's this?
It's for me to know and you to find out.
Whoa, wait, is that buzzing coming from?
Take control and find out.
Oh.
The supermarket was just our first stop on our like list of things to do that day.
So why not give it a shot there? It was the first place we could be in an area that there was other people and to see her reaction.
And me, I'm just doing my normal shopping and every so often I have this like little buzz going on. And I'm looking around like, where is he? Because he was nowhere in sight at this point.
I was peering and sneaking around the corners like, so that when I did press it, I could see her reaction, which was something I tried to do when she had her hands full so that when I did do it, she would drop everything or stumble or something.
Wow!
Excuse me?
This is strong cheese. Have you tried this cheese? This is great. Gee, this is the best. And bananas. These are great bananas. These are awesome bananas. Thanks.
I got absolutely no grocery shopping done that day. I didn't pick one thing out. In fact, we really didn't get anything done that day.
Yeah. So I like have a bag in one hand and my apple like in another and I'm just like checking it out and all of a sudden I start like buzzing again. I'm like, okay, like this is feeling like really good. Like, I'm staring obviously way too long at this one apple. I'm like, wow, this is getting really intense.
Well, I kind of was still in a funny mood because I'm still thinking that I was the one that made her fall down. So when I approached her, I was like, wow, was it good?
Whoa, was that good? Hey, Ashley, hey, are you okay?
It really hurt.
Oh, baby, you got a huge lump on your head.
His idea was to take me to the emergency room.
Come on, we gotta go. We gotta get to the hospital.
When we got to the ER, didn't really go into much detail.
Or how she fell, like,
yeah.
That was described.
No, not at all.
Hey, how hard did you hit your head?
She hit it really hard. I'm worried about her.
All right, we'll get a nurse to take you to the ER bay.
Thanks.
I still had the thing in my pants. I like totally forgot it was still in there.
Babe. Oh, babe, the button is stuck.
Oh, I forgot. I even still had this on.
Hurry. Don't worry. Everything's
going
to be okay.
Hurry, the nurse is coming.
I'm trying to turn it. It's not turning on.
What is going on here?
One of the most embarrassing moments of my life. Oh, my gosh.
Hello there. I see that.
We thought we could hide it at the grocery store. Now we can't even hide it at the hospital.
No, yeah.
It's just totally up
there.
It
was like
now.
One thing after the next. It was just not on our side.
What is that? Greta, what is that noise?
I'm sorry, I don't know, doctor.
Now I'm completely exposed, like totally traumatized.
It's a buzzing sound.
Gosh, it was just super, super embarrassing.
Miss, is there something else about your condition we should know about?
Actually, I...
Would someone please let me know what's going on here?
To explain that to somebody that is a complete stranger, like you have no idea.
I didn't just slip and hit my head in the supermarket. We have a remote control vibrator, and it is in my pants still, and it was really intense, so like.
I did not want anything to do with that toy any longer.
Well then, the nurse is gonna take you down the hall for a CAT scan. I suggest you remove anything foreign before you get inside the machine.
Of course.
We see a lot of patients that come to the ER because sex brought them there. There's, you know, always the case of the sex toy gone awry. I have a feeling that a lot of those, they don't tell us the true story. They just say they fell or something, but it really happened from sex. Occasionally you'll see someone who's like completely honest with you.
We'll be back in a bit. We're just gonna do a little blood work and then get some fresh ice for her bump.
First you wanna find out, were they knocked unconscious? Because studies have kind of shown if you were knocked unconscious, you have a higher risk of bleeding in the brain. And so that would lead us down the path of wanting to do more testing.
Thanks for your patience. Have the results of Ashley's scat scan.
Is she gonna be all right?
Ashley has a minor concussion. She's gonna have to take it easy for a few days. Rest and drink plenty of water.
What you're watching out for with concussions is to make sure they're not getting worse and getting a more severe headache, also repetitive episodes of vomiting. If that was to occur, then you worry that the concussion's evolved into bleeding. And that's most concerning and should be closely watched for in the first 48 hours.
Great, so there's no permanent damage?
No, none at all. You dodged a bullet. However, I would suggest that you keep the fun and games at home and not in a public place.
Yep.
Okay, carry on, kids.
I kind of want to throw that remote out the window.
I wanted to destroy it. I wanted to like blow it up. I did not want to see it.
You know, I think I might have a better idea for this thing.
Sex toys could help your relationship. Is it something that I need anymore? No.
We really don't need batteries to have a good time. Woo!